Hello, Fairless.
Today is Friday, December 16th.
And this is Falcon Media.
Today on Falcon Media, we have Idiot Test,
Voice of Democracy winner with Nathaniel Schmidt,
McDonald's window painting by Art 3,
The Lion King in face painting,
girls basketball highlights,
wrestling highlights,
let's talk about Christmas,
Christmas trivia,
all I want for you, Christmas lip sync,
and Christmas cheer in our community.
Welcome to the Idiot Test!
Can you draw a triangle with two lines?
Yes.
Can you draw a triangle with two lines?
I would say no.
Can you draw a triangle with two lines?
Triangle two lines.
What?
No.
Do you want to try?
No.
You're just giving up?
Yes.
Sorry.
Probably not. No.
Are you going to try?
Sure. No.
Do you want to try it all?
Sure.
That is incorrect.
How?
This does not count as a line.
We're assuming an infinite plane of white hole.
It's only the edge. I mean, it's close.
Well, that is not...
That's a point. That's a point right there.
Cold. Artist.
Duh, I should be an art. Triangle with two lines.
Yes.
And it has been done.
It has been done. You can do it.
Is it like something on the back?
No, there's nothing on the back.
Here, I'll even show the camera there's nothing on the back.
This kid in the Falcon Media will even include my like seconds of awkwardness and indecision.
That's two.
That's a triangle.
Do you give up?
No. There's no such thing as giving. I give up.
Artist aficionado.
I don't think that's possible, because triangles have three sides.
That is writing, not drawing.
That draw a triangle with two lines?
Yeah.
That is incorrect.
It's a triangle, there are two lines there. She didn't say anything about it having a third.
Okay, I guess that counts.
Yeah.
That is not a triangle. You got it right! That's a triangle with two lines.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That is a triangle with two lines.
Oh my God. You have nothing to say for yourself?
That is a triangle with two lines.
This is stupid.
Got me.
I can't do it.
Why isn't this working? That is a triangle with two lines.
Kill me.
When I think of being a responsible American citizen, things like effort, progress, and character come to mind.
I wrote my Voice Democracy essay because we had to do it for AP Government, and I thought it was all right when I read it, so I decided to just turn it into the competition. Right now, nothing. For the local one, I won, I think Ms. Haswell said $100, and the district level, or the state level I'm going to right now, I'm guaranteed at least 2,000. I got to express my thoughts about some things that were going on in America today with current generations and some problems that we were facing.
Would we not have established civil rights for women and minorities if it weren't for the will and progressive ideas of our people? Perhaps we would still be a colony of Great Britain if it were not for the outstanding efforts of our forefathers to establish an independent nation.
The final prize is a $30,000 grant for college, and the way I see it, that's pretty much the only way of me going to college without selling myself to the student loans. In January, the weekend of the 15th, I will be going to Columbus for a banquet and seminar. I'm one of the 12 winners, and we'll be going to determine who wins the state level to go to the national, and that's where I'll go from there.
We have caused civil unrest between our entire population, mostly through bigotry and hatred.
Kind of. I'm nervous, very nervous. I hope so, but I don't know. I didn't really think it would be that well received when I wrote it.
The media, such as television and the internet, has provided a great thing for America, making information and ways of communication easier than ever to gain access to. However, these tools can also be used to cause problems by hate mongers and disrespectful people.
On Wednesday, November 30th, Shelby Greene, Taylor Fetters, McKenna Gunlack, Michaela Farmer, Jessica Durbin, Gabby Brindley, and Miss Holland all went to the Route 21 McDonald's to paint the windows with holiday cheer. Stop by McDonald's to see the amazing artwork done by these talented artists.
Broadway, a street best known for its theatrical performances, especially for one of its highest-selling acts, The Lion King, was one of the focuses of Miss Jones' theater class. They studied various elements of theater performances, some including puppetry, set design, costumes, and makeup. The class then examined The Lion King that was performed in Broadway to see how professionals utilized these elements, specifically makeup. Each student first drew sketches of what they may have wanted to recreate. They then brought the sketches to life by drawing their creations on each other's faces, ready for showtime.
can't stop.
Wrestling. On December 9th and 10th, the wrestling team went to Smithville to wrestle in the Wayne Invitational. Falcons had two places, with Nick Shepard placing second and Ben Rugg placing third.
What type of pie filling is popular during Christmas time?
Pie filling? Apple.
Pumpkin.
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 Who lost $8,000 in It's a Wonderful Life?
Never seen that movie. Can I get a hint? I've never seen the movie. How can you ask a question about a movie I've never seen?
It's an uncle and then a name.
Uncle Buck?
No.
I know, right?
Oh, crap. There was a guy. Jimmy Stewart. How about that?
I don't know.
I have no clue what that means. No.
What country started the tradition of exchanging gifts?
China?
That'd be the Germans.
I'm going to say the United States of America.
Oh, Italy.
What did elves wear at the tip of their shoes?
Elves wear at the tip of their shoes? It's bells, right? Little tiny bells.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Bells?
Cotton balls.
Bells?
Brendon said cotton balls.
What Christmas ballet is famous of them all?
Dreaming of a White Christmas?
The Nutcracker.
Christmas Ballet. The Nutcracker.
The Nutcracker.
Well, I'll probably be, like, watching TV the whole time, and I also need to find a good present for my girlfriend.
I plan to overeat.
No, I don't. I just plan on sleeping and eating.
I do not know of as right now. I know I'm going to go to my grandma's. And then for New Year's, I know I'm going to go skating at Columbia Skate Room. I don't think Santa Claus will mind
you. He won't ever. Well, for the first time in like 10 years, I'm actually not going to Canada for Christmas. I'm going to be staying home for the whole entirety of winter break.
We like to listen to Christmas music together, and we watch Elf every year like 20 million times.
No.
We have a tradition of... Nothing.
My family tradition, one of them, is every New Year's Eve we go to my great-grandma's house, and we celebrate the Christ of God's birth, and then... We have fun and eat cake and blow candles out.
Not really.
No. Yes, I am. If her mom allows it, I'm gonna send my girlfriend something in the mail for Christmas, because she doesn't live around here.
I'm not telling.
Not that I know of. I still have to buy everybody's stuff.
Not at the moment. I'm kind of a blank. I'm getting my family anything for Christmas. There's lots of room for him in our two-car garage. I'd feed him there.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents. My wish come true. All I want for Christmas is you.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store, but the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and we'll go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well. It's the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
That's all for today, Fairless.
See you next week on Falcon Media.